Hello everyone, good day and welcome again to our ABE 197 class, which is the methods of research for ABE. So the last time we have discussed already the processes or the research process, which involved from introduction down to conclusion or even the acknowledgement, references, and the abstract. So just a recap. The difference between a full polished paper and the thesis is that the thesis is the most detailed one, which is covers from the abstract down to references and acknowledgement, and all the data, all the specific methods has to be included. While for the papers, research papers, you just have to select a certain part of your research or thesis, like a certain objective, and then the data of that particular objective, and so on. Okay, so I believe that you are already, you already learned about the basics of research process. How will you do the literature survey? How will you write or analyze the data? How will you arrange and interpret the data? And how will you relate or cite related studies of your current research, particularly on the proper literature survey and writing? So this time I will be talking with how to select a problem, how to identify the research problem of your particular research or your particular inquiry, your particular thoughts. For example, you are being required for your subject or for your degree, for your course, to conduct a thesis, and then currently you are thinking of what are the possible topics that you want to conduct, to pursue. So the first thing that you need to do is to learn the processes of research, which I already discussed. So I guess that you are already aware with how the thesis or the title has to be identified. And this time, let's move on. Let's continue with how to select or identify your research problem. Okay, so allow me to share with you my presentation. Okay. Accordingly, to one of my references, which is a very important and a very full package book, which I have usually mentioned in my presentations, research problem or identification of research problem is the most critical. Okay, before I have mentioned that selecting a conducting literature survey or even writing introduction and writing your manuscript is a very critical and a very important part. It plays a very crucial part in your research endeavor. However, let us not forget that you cannot conduct the study or you cannot conduct the research, particularly if you have not identified your problem. So most references would always say that selecting a research problem is like the root, right? It's like the seedling of a tree. You cannot come up with everything. You cannot grow with everything or anything without identifying your the root or the cause of your endeavor. So selecting research problem is the one that you have to consider after considering your topic, right? So this lecture will give us or will define us what the research problem all about. Okay, we will learn how the research problem differs from all the steps or processes involved in conducting research, and how can we select the problem if we already have the topic. Like mostly, most researchers, particularly or especially novice researchers, will have a broad kind of topic. Usually, it's like a broad one, like non-specific. Some would say, "Okay, I will do this. How I will study about this." But the problem is that too narrow? Is that too specific? Is that your capacity, technical capacity, your knowledge regarding that particular topic is enough to or sufficient enough to conduct that particular study? So why not specify the problem of that particular research? As I have mentioned in my previous presentations, that you have to be specific. From being a narrow one or broad one, you have to be specific in order for you to achieve the study. It's not easy to conduct a study alone or just a group of two or three, and then you have a lot of, or your study is so broad. So you have to select the problem specifically. And why it is necessary for us, why it is important to narrow down, or I mean to be specific with the problems that we want to solve or we want to address. So we will learn based on this presentation. And some techniques that might be helpful or might be important that you can apply in your personal or your own research, wherein you can easily or you can achieve your research on time. So some techniques are being introduced in this presentation. Okay? What is a research problem, by the way? So accordingly, in the research process, defining a research problem is the first and foremost step that usually happens. Okay, so the last time I have told you that identifying the research or your topic is one of the first step. And then identifying your research problem is just identifying your research problem or your topic. And then what will happen? Okay, so the most important part of identifying your topic is identifying the problem. Why you have come up with this problem? Why you have come up with this research? So that's the most important one. Because thinking about the topic is also thinking about what the problem that you want to address to, right? For example, you are required to conduct a thesis or a research in order for you to graduate the degree or the program. Then you are thinking of a certain situation that you think might help you or might help you personally, academically, and will help the community. So you are thinking, how will you address that problem? For example, a certain community in your specific area, or I mean nearby your hometown, a specific community like a group of farmers are feeling a difficulty in terms of processing the particular product. There's already a commodity, but there's nothing or there's no innovation, there's no development that is happening, no? So in terms of financial, they cannot afford to do that. In terms of technicalities, they are not knowledgeable enough to study or to innovate something, okay? Or in terms of socioeconomic, they are not aware that their practices and their techniques are too old, too conventional, right? So they are not capable enough. What they think is that they can have an income, they can just harvest, and they can just earn the small amount without thinking anything like a value added product. Okay, so that's something that is interesting that you can innovate something, you can add up something, a new idea, right? So it's the most important step in doing a research, in doing the research, in identifying first the problem or the situation that you want to address. Because as I have told you, conducting research without addressing a certain problem is not a research at all. Because as an engineer, as a technician, as a scientist, we are obliged. We are that professionals who are expected to help the community, to help the less fortunate beneficiaries, right? So you have to identify, you have to think, not just because you want to graduate, but because your aim is to help a certain group or a certain community, a certain group of farmers, or even a certain problem in your community that can uplift or can change the way or even their traditional and malpractices. Okay, so the goal is to somehow change the current or the traditional way of doing this, okay, of processing or transporting or of harvesting this product. So that's the main goal of ABS. Okay, a researcher also accordingly must find the problem and formulate it to that it becomes a susceptible research. Again, I have already mentioned this, to find the problem and formulate it. Okay, find a problem and formulate it. I mean, that's why most of the studies or most of the theses of the students will say statement of the problem, and then most statements are in question. Okay, I don't know if you have experienced reading a thesis or thesis manuscript or dissertation manuscript, that most there are some problem statements that, for example, what will be the impact of this design to the production? For example, let's an example. What will be the materials involved in this design? What are the benefits? Okay, what is the efficiency and the capacity of this machine? Ang uban maingon. Okay, some statements in question are also like, what will be the average or average range or average capacity of this water in terms of like this and like that? Okay, so most statement of the problems are in question. But some researchers are not encouraged to state the problems in question, and then because it's quite confusing or it's quite annoying to see that the statement of the problems are in question, because as a researcher, it is our goal to address that particular question. And then statement of the problem now, most particularly in thesis or in manuscripts, are being stated in a paragraph form and not in question. But before, I have even read a lot of articles or thesis that the statement of the problems are in question, like as in question mark. Okay, because you are thinking of something that you want to solve or to address, but you are still in question of that particular problem. You can only answer that after doing the study when you already have the data. That's why before, mostly, some of the studies are, statement of the problem of some of the studies are in question. Say, for instance, a medical doctor as a researcher must examine all the symptoms. Okay, like magpakonsulta sa doctor, ang doctor is a scientist and a researcher as well, because a doc may akong gipangbati doc kay gihilantan ko giubo mauni mauna, and then the doctor will have a lot of questions to throw, like okay, unsa pa may lain, mauni mauna, and then after that it's like data gathering, right? It's like a confirmation, and then nanalay susception ang doctor, okay, maybe somehow mauni iyang sakit, and then after the clinical results correlate with the references of the doctor, like giubo, gisipun, and then the clinical results, the chemical and the biological results of the patient will confirm or will correlate, will relate with the kantong mga symptoms nga nagather sa doctor. So it's a research. It's just a matter of a simple research, but actually it's still a research, right? What are the problem? Okay, na siya sakit. Okay, unsa kaha, no? The question is unsa kaya sakit, no? I don't know. Diba? I don't know unsa iyang sakit, even if I am the doctor. I will only know after gathering the data, after confirming based on the data or the lab results. So that's just a simple concept of the research, okay? And then after defining the problem, na define na unsa kayang sakit, questions unsa pud kayang ipaminaw, okay, pila na kaadlaw siya na ingani. And then after that, after confirming based on the lab results and based on the physical exam made by the doctor, then the doctor can know what's the problem is. Ma-confirm niya, okay, maybe the assumption is ang sakit nagka-dengue, dili di based on the results. So just like the research, okay, siguro after doing this, okay, it will solve or it will shorten the processing time of the farmers or the food processors. And then after doing the AI, mas paspas pa diay ang manual machine, ang manual kaysa sa imong machine nga na-develop, or sa imong study or mixture nga na-develop kaysa sa katong ilang mixture nga na-apply, mas effective pa diay after doing the study. So the study will confirm and the study will give you the exact or the specific results. Dili kay okay, feeling na ako, tama gini, mao gini nga design, mao gini nga size sa blade nga para makaputol siya yung ani, mas pas-pas. No, it's not, the research is not like that. The research has to be confirmed with the data. Okay? By definition, a research problem refers to some difficulty, okay, which a researcher experiences in the context of either a theoretical or practical situation and wants to obtain a solution for the same. Okay, balik-balik lang. A research problem must be a problem by from the term problem. Dapat problema siya nga ma-address or i-address. Okay? Not necessarily nga ma-address gyud 100%. Okay? Kay even experts, for example, balik ta sa example nga doctor, na may uban patients gyud nga after confirming with the lab results and the physical exam, then prescribe ang doctor og tambal usay di pagyapon maulian. Maybe somehow wala pa na address gyud or wala gyud natumpak ang diagnosis or ang findings. So that's even the research like that. Okay? Experimental research or engineering research. Dili gyud some people would say, okay, palpak man imong study, sayop man na. Okay, let's accept if it's palpak, but a research is a learning process. It's a process. Dili pwede nga nag-research ka, perfect na yun. Okay? Nagka-problema na ang community. Ang ilang problema is ang quality sa tubig. Okay? Nya, ang gibuhat sa researcher kay, nagkuha lang siya og sample sa tubig, gitest, and then after testing, nag-analyze lang siya, and then nag-ingon siya nga mauni ang mga chemical, biological nga mga results. So, you are not solving in a way. You are just testing. A problem must be, okay, what's the problem? The people are experiencing diarrhea after drinking that waters from that water source. And then you conduct a study, you collect the data, and then you do the analysis. And then you share or you educate them on what are the effects of this particular result. For example, it has a high fecal coliform value. And then you educate the people that the results shows that the water quality is bad or the water quality is not on its index or normal index. And then what may be the solution? Okay, maybe there are some filtering system that you might put or you might apply on that particular water source. Okay, there's a lot like a biomass. Filtering or any natural filtering or even chemical filtering. So you are solving the problem after gathering the symptoms or after gathering the initial findings. Because kanang okay, gusto na ako i-test ang tubig diha kay water quality akong study. I want to test the water quality. I want to analyze the water quality of our kanang waterfalls nga diha mi nagkuha og source sa among barangay. Okay, after testing that, then you have got the data, and then you compare with the international standard or the national standard if it belongs or it's still on the not normal range. And then wala di ay igura ka nag-analyze, wala ka. And then what's the solution? Maybe you design or you propose any filtering system or any kanang gitawag nila nga kanang magchlorinate ka, kanang gitawag nila magdisinfection or something, anything like that. So you are solving the problem. Pero kung mag-research lang ka nga, igura ka nagkuhag data and then analyze, it's not a solving research. It's just observational research somehow. Okay? So dapat makasolve ka. In all research endeavors, the research problem should be clearly defined and the research objective should be smart. Okay? What the smart? Dili smart nga ka ng network, okay? Mobile network. Smart, which means specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. Okay? Very easy to understand. A specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. Okay? Okay. Specific ka dapat unsa imong gusto i-solve or unsa ang problem nga gusto nimo i-address. Measurable, masukod. Kay lisod pug sigira tag state sa atong problem pero wala tay thinking on the methods on how we can solve that. Okay? Achievable. Achievable in such a way nga ma-achieve through technical experience at technical expertise or through your review of related literature, ma-achieve na based sa mga existing atong i-refer, no, as reference na to how to solve or how to measure. Okay, realistic, dapat way halong twisting story nga mao ni ang problem, imo lang i-twist nang opiyara ka sa existing study, which is lahi ang niyang method. So it's not realistic. And time bound, you should be conscious with your time range or your time duration sa imong study. Dili pwede nga ang imong study is tulo ra ka objective na abtan kag 1 year, na abtan kag isa ka sem. So dili na siya. It depends on the level or it depends on the weight of your problem. So ingana dapat smart. Again, smart for research problem identification means specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. Okay. There are some conditions because usually we say that a research problem does exist if the following conditions are met, no? Makaingon lang ta nga research problem ni siya kung ingani ang akong masugatan. For example, you are now thinking, okay? You are now thinking unsa imong gusto ma-study, okay? Unsa imong gusto i-conduct as your thesis. So I want you to think now, what do you want to conduct? Okay. So for example, ikaw ha, ikaw, I want you to think now for 1 to 2 minutes. Okay. Ako mismo, ang akong gusto nga mahitabo, nga i-conduct is, I want to study the quality characteristics of high-valued crops in Caraga region. Okay. High-valued crops include like cacao, coffee, coconut, and other kanang mga mahalun nga mga crops nga rare kaayo pod or kanang specific to regions lang gid siya nga gina-produce. So like mango, cacao, coffee, coconut. I want to study their quality using spectroscopic techniques. I mean, kanang ako lang siyang duulon using the technology, ako na dayon siyang ako lang siyang murag pusilon. Then mahibal-an ako based sa akong system nga nabilong pa siya sa quality based sa image niya. Or na ako'y naka-conveyor type, na ako'y naka-conveyor type nga ipamutang rato na ako tanan ng mga samples, murid na dahin si image, i-capture niya ang katong nagdagan sa conveyor, katong mga samples nga nagdagan sa conveyor, i-capture ni, picturean ni kanang system, and then i-process niya sa computer, niya makita din dito ang ma-predict niya kung pila ang soluble solids, pila ang iyang moisture, pila ang ana based sa reference. So that's my thinking. So I want you to think also of yours, okay? So I want you to think. Okay. Tan-aw na to if ang imong na-think is possible siya or researchable siya based sa mga conditions according sa atong book as reference. Okay, so I guess you are now you have something that you have considered as possible as might be your topic. Okay, so mao tong ako. So I want you to think your own. Okay, so tanaw na to. What are the conditions? The first one, there must be an individual, okay, or a group of an organization, sama sa akong giingon, or farmers or beneficiaries, to whom the problem can be attributed. Okay, I hope nga ang inyong na-think there are some farmers or beneficiaries or a group of people na maka-benefit or maka-attribute. The individual or the organization, as the case may be, occupies an environment which as can be denoted as N or the population, okay? Which is defined as by values of the uncontrolled variables Y. So sila ang nag-represent sa population which is uncontrolled variable sila, okay? And then there must be at least 2 courses of action. For example, action 1 and action 2. Okay? A course of action is defined by one or more variables of the controlled variables. For example, the number of items purchased at a specified time is said to be 1 course of action. So, kaniyang example, ang iyang sigurong research is mostly related to like marketing or business. Okay? The action 1 is related to purchased number of products purchased. Okay. Maybe the other action is related to the income, okay, or related to the business hours. So, ingana ba? There must be a 2 course of actions. Okay. Ang ikatulo condition, there must be at least 2 possible outcomes. Say example, outcome 1 and outcome 2 of the course of action, of which one should be preferable to the other. In other words, this means that there must be at least 1 outcome that the researcher wants. For example, wanted to do as an objective. For example, ganina sa example is first niya nga condition, first niya nga course of action is kadtong purchased number of products purchased. The other one is maybe the income or the business hours. Unsa ilang relationship ba? Unsa kahay resulta if kani ang akong objective or kani ang akong condition. Okay? And then, ingon sa condition 3, must be at least 2 possible outcomes. Unsa kay outcomes? So sa condition 1 niya, okay? Ay sa course of action 1 yan, course of action 2 dapat napunto sila yung mga resulta after doing the research. So maon ni sa ang condition 3, okay? So you think also of yours. Unsa ka after considering your research problem? Unsa pud ka ang mga outcomes if kani nga design akong gamiton, kung nang machine ka, if mag-assessment ka, what if kani nga survey akong gamiton? So maingana ba nga mga actions. Ang condition 4, the courses of action available must provide some chance of obtaining the objective, but they cannot provide the same chance, otherwise the choice would not matter. What does it mean? For example, na nakakantong imong ga-identify, no? Okay, example, ang akong example diha is ang condition 1, ang iyang action 1 is number of purchased products. Ang isa is business hours. So, after that, gi-identify na nimo sa kayang mga resulta if ma-change ang imong treatment, no? Ang iyang condition 4 ni ingon, the courses of action available must provide some chance of obtaining the objective, but they cannot provide the same chance, otherwise the choice would not matter. Okay, katong imong condition nga giset or treatment nga giset, if dili to siya related sa imong study, for example, ang imong gusto nga i-come up is katong purchased kuan products, ang isa is katong business hours, no? Unya ang imong gistudyahan, ang imong gikuha og data is ang mga persons, okay, or pila ka tao ka ang nag pila ka tao ang staff nga present atong adlaw, dili siya related. Dapat, because your study is more on the purchased products, ang imong account, pila ka customer di ay nanulod ang adlaw. And the other course of action is, for example, is, di ba ang akong example is kadtong business hours. So, pila ka kauras pod, no? Tama ba? 8 hours ba ang ilang business hours sa kana ang adlaw? So, i-compute imo na silang i-note. No? Dili kay, ang imong course of action, nag-treatment ni mo, is more on the purchased products unya ang imong gistudyahan pila ka personahe ang present or nag-duty atong adlaw, so di siya related, so there must be a relationship. Over and above these conditions, the individual or the organization can be said to have the problem. Okay, so ma-identify gini mo nga na ay problem, no, na kay dapat ma-solve ana, na kay dapat ma-research ana. If it's if there's a problem, it means there's a research. Okay. It is a researchable area. So, inga na siya. Pag naay problema, researchable na siya. Okay. Dili kay, unsa may problema di diha? Okay. Ang problema, sir, kay ang traffic, kuan ba? Kanang traffic, gihapon, bisag na naay traffic light. Okay. Unsa may lagi problema, ana? Okay. Kuan, sir, siguro, ang traffic light, di siguro kulang gid ang iyang time. No? Or, mubo ra kayo kay 60 seconds ra or 60 minutes. So, dili na siya mao ang problema. Maybe the problem is the overpopulation or crowded na gyud ang kanang number of cars or vehicles. The other problem might be ang dalan or ang pedestrian or even the kanang diversion road wala gi-apply. So, dili ka pwede mag-research based ra sa kanang assume based ra sa imong kanang pagsabot, no, dili pwede na nga. Okay, maybe ingani ang problema ana kay dili. So researchable na siya if no one of you or even the experts cannot answer, no. So researchable na siya nga part. So napo tay gitawag nga components of a research problem, guys. Okay? Accordingly, an individual or a group of persons can be said to have a problem which can be technically described as a research problem if the following components are met. Okay? So pwede pud nato matawag daw nga problema ni or researchable ni if kaning mga conditions ang ma-met. Okay? So the first one is, component one is, there must be an individual or a group which has some difficulty or the problem. Okay? If you are aware with the math operations research, because on the our curriculum before, naami subject na operations research. For example, mangita mig problema related to operations. Okay? For example, matukag bangko, and then mag-observe ka sa bangko, unsa gyud ka problema ni, no? Nga, pagsulod na ko sa bangko, na i-guard mo sugat. Okay. Pagsugat sa guard, unsa imo, sir? Magunsa ka, sir? Okay. Mag-withdraw, mag-deposit. Okay, kung withdraw, diri ka, mao ni ang form. Kung mag-deposit, diri ka, mao ni ang form. Okay. Kung mag-open kag bank account, mao ni diri imong lingkuran, mao pud ni imong fill upan, unya mao pud ni nga clerk or window ang imong tangatawagon ka, magtan-aw ka. So nanay process, no? Nanay operation nga process. Imo pag yung obserbahan, unsa pagiga problema. Okay. Okay, sige kag sige mig observe. What may be the problem? Okay, operations problem. That's for the business. Ah, I will give you another example for the engineering part. The problem may be, no, nga akong na observe is ang time, no, allotment per customer. Okay, mao ta akong giunaw na that time. Maybe for the customer because why the people queuing or lining in this group for withdrawal or deposit, okay, or for like over the counter withdrawal, paspas man kay sila, okay, though the process the same. However, kaning diri nga magpa cash in ra or magpa in cash ra og check kay dugay man kaayo. After 15 minutes isa lang, after 30 minutes duha lang ang na cater. Samantala didto nga mag-open pa og bank account, dali ra man nga mas daghan man tug fill upan og something. Maybe there's a time. So the researchable area is the problem might be are the clerks or the staff that are not aware with their action or performance, no nga. Di sila aware that the time lapsed more than 30 minutes for one client. So it's not a good business strategy or a business practice. It's a problem. How to solve that? So di ana dayon ka mosulod. Unsa kaha? So yung mikanda ka survey or and so on and so on and then analyze the data and then implement. Okay. So that's the how the research researchable area, how to identify the researchable area. For the engineering to be specific, dili na ako mag-machine kay sige ra kong think about machine. Okay, for example, let's go back with the community. Okay. That particular community has a group of farmers, a group of 50 farmers. Okay. Their struggle is mechanization. They have no machines or they have no high-tech machines or high-end machines to cultivate, to help them cultivate their farms or their land. Is that a problem already? Might be a problem. But the most specific problem is what is the most applicable machinery? What is the most applicable machinery or machine that they can use to make them more efficient in terms of their farming? Pangutana ka. Unsa ka ha? Ang pangutana, do they know how to operate a machine? If the answer is yes, the problem might somehow, they have no resources or they have no machines to use. Okay, that might be. The other option or condition that I have mentioned before earlier is if the answer is no, they do not know how to operate a machine, so the main problem might be they have no idea on the mechanization. So the answer, the solution is you have to train them or you have to orient them to educate them what are the available mechanization or machines that they can apply in order for them to to cultivate their land more efficiently. So dili pwede nga mag-ingon ra ka nga ang problema gid ana no kay kana sila nga 50 ka farmers ang problema ana nga anong gagmay ra sila gani tungod kay wa sila machine. No, you cannot say that. What if dili pud gid sila kabalo mo operate? Okay? What if dili gid pud sila kabalo wa gid sila na aware nga naa dayay mga advanced technologies and machineries that they can use. Okay? So that's the conditional nga akong gi-mention ganina. Okay? That's two conditions for example or two ka situations ba nga. If kani ang kana unsa pud kay outcome ani ug unsay outcome ani, okay. That might be a two researchable area. Okay, what if, okay, the first question, mga sir, no, mga sir, ang group of 50 farmers, do you know that there are a lot of machines or high end machines that you can use in, you can apply or you can use to cultivate your land? It is a mechanized to mechanize your farming activities. Wala kabalo. If yes, do they know to operate? May nga na ba ang mga questions? So you can sit, you can go with that, you can come with that, and then think of the possible problems or researchable situation that you can do. So yung ana, pag-identify sa problem, di kay, sa kaya akong thesis, no, somehow, or I guess akong thesis is, ingnon ra ko ni Sir Philip, unsay nindot. Ingnon ra ko ni Sir Tado, ni Sir Abduhan, unsay nindot. No. You have to identify anything that you want to contribute to the community. And if it's a problem, you will know why there's an existing deficiency or there's an existing lack of activities or innovations or technical support for that particular community or group of individuals. So, ingana siya pag-solve ha. Di kayo nag-study. Sa may mong research, nag-identify kong quality sa Mingo. Ganong nag-identify mga quality sa Mingo? Para makapasar ko, no. Nag-identify ka because one of the most complicated or one of the most issues in mango production is the non-identification of their quality. Saglit kay hinog na, okay na. So may nga na ba? Okay? So the next component is there must be some objectives to be attained, at if one wants nothing, one cannot have a problem. There must be some objectives to be attained. Okay? If one wants nothing, one cannot have a problem. Okay? Wala. Wala man kay gitink nga problem nga gusto nimo i-solve. So wala kay objective ma-identified. Then wala. Di siya researchable. Okay? For example, katong i-continue na ako katong sa farmers, what if the farmers doesn't know? Oh, the farmers are technically have know-how, technically have know-how on the operations of machines. And then, ikaw po nga nag-research, igura ka nag-interview, wala kay intervention, wala ni mag-yunahuna, unsa kay possible ani. Mag-educate ba ko as a research? And then, after educating them, after training them with operating of a tractor and a mudboat tiller or whatever, i-assess na ko sila if nagin sila ng capacity or capability nga mo operate. So that's a research. Gi-research na nimo, gi-train nimo, and then gi-assess nimo, gi-evaluate kung kabalo. And then, you solve. Okay? You are done with your first objective, which is to train or educate the people. Okay? So ingana siya ha, dapat naagyoy objectives. Kung wala, wala good. There must be alternative means or the courses of action for obtaining the objectives one wishes to attain. Okay? This means that there must be at least two means available to the researcher for if he has no choice of means, he cannot have a problem. Okay. Balik ko sa akong problem. Balik ko. Ang farmers may ingon, yes, kabalo mi. Yes. Aware ba mo nga na mga technologies or machineries nga pwede? Yes, kabalo po mi. Nga ikaw, kay kabalo man di ay, ikaw nga researcher, kay nakabalo na ka nga, sila di ay mga farmers, kabalo. Ah, kabalo man di ay mo, nga nung wala man mo nag-apply. Nga, kabalo po mo nga mahal. Oh, kabalo po mi. Nga man mo nag-apply. Anong wala man mo nagamit or wala man mo nangayo sa government? Wala lang. Ikaw po, wala lang. So what are the possible means? What are the possible anang mga pasikot-sikot nga imo gitong masolve nga problem? And then after that, ma-realize din mo nga, dili gid ay problema tong kuan kanang ka-remote sa ilang area nga wala sila technologies. Maybe the main problem, maybe, assuming, after doing the research or educating them or conducting or gathering the data, you will find that lack of support from the government and lack of kanang assistance from the government might be the problem. That might be the problem. Dili gid ang ilang kay ang farmers bisan pagtudloan nimo na isa ra ka adlaw makabalo gid na sila because they have the eagerness, they have the willingness to learn whatever that will benefit or will increase their productivity. Okay? I don't know if you are familiar with that. I hope that most ABA students are farmer oriented or have the heart in terms of farming, because I am a farmer. I am raised by a farmer, and I have born and raised by a farmer, and then I have been I experienced farming by myself, and then I was working with the SWD before with the fisher folks and the farmers. I know how they felt, no? I know their struggles. That's why I want to encourage you to immerse you with the world of agriculture in learning on the struggles and calls of the farmers. Because later on, especially when you practice the profession, it's not a good it's not a good idea that you will just like, for example, you are working with the Department of Agriculture. You are tasked to immerse yourself to the farmers, interview the farmers, and do this, and then research this, if what are their problems really all about. And then, ikaw, kay gusto lang nimo nga swildo, gusto lang nimo nga maka-addto ka, mangayo kag certificate of attendance or whatever, nga nag-addto ka sa community without addressing their concerns, without noting their races. So, wala. No? So, I hope that most ABEs have the heart in terms of farming or have the bisag idea man lang what's the farming all about, what's the real situation of farming, no? Kay naadiha daghan kay researchable areas sa farming, guys. There are a lot of things to settle and issues to consider in farming, no? I'm even thinking why the farmers are still poor wherein we are an agricultural country, no? We are very rich in terms of agriculture and production. We have a lot of commodities, no? In other countries, okay, particularly in developing countries like Malaysia, Thailand, farmers are really, I mean, on high, I mean, they are well off, they are on the their track, no, dili kay sa atua. Okay, anyway, so I just want to, this is just an ad lib that most ABEs, I mean, I strongly suggest that the ABEs have the heart for farmers or agriculture. Dili kay gusto lang tamo graduate, because at the end of the day, the profession, okay, most successful professionals are those really have the heart in terms of the call for their profession. Okay, so inga na ha, problem lang gani atong problem, problem lang gani atong topic, pero na incorporate na to ang problems in terms of farming. Kay dahagi diha tanan, dili kay mag-research lang kay makagraduate. So we will research, we conduct research to help or to alter the current practices that might be changed after doing this research. Okay, the next component is there must remain some doubt in the mind of a researcher with regard to the selection of alternatives. So unsa kaha, ingon man sila nga di sila kabalo, no, sila kabalo mo operate, and then ingon pud sila nga aware sila, or there is a support from the government pero wala nila giatiman. There are some of beneficiaries or farmers associations that already had a lot of machineries or support. It's either financial or facilities or machineries na ginahatag sa government, but they are not operating it because of the lack of training. So pwede po na siya nga problem. Naanay gihatag ang government nga funding para ma-operate nila ang ilang association, dili po nila mapalago because of lack of entrepreneurial capabilities. So it might be a problem, an alternative problem for that particular situation. So daghan gyud guys, daghan gyud dag masundlan nga researchable. That's why I have one student advisee now who is doing profiling and technical evaluation of existing warehouses in Caraga region. What she's doing is she want to assess the level of assistance, I mean the level the quality of that particular warehouses, agricultural warehouses in Caraga. And then she will assess if that warehouse address or conforms with the national standards in terms of the structure of the warehouse. That particular study will also know if that warehouse is suitable for that particular area. Kay basin ka na nga warehouse are good for rice, pero ang ila din production are corn. No, that study will also profile the capability of the farmers. How will they manage their association? That study will also give us an emphasis or results on the capacity of the warehouse. Pila ka iyang capacity, kung sa nga crops ang iyang ginakater. And then that study will also evaluate technically, okay, and scientifically, the social impact. No? Sa kay impact, nakapakwartahan ba siya sa mga farmers? Mas nilago ba ang ilang farming? Mas ni-income ba sila? Okay? Na mas nilago ba ang gihatag sa ila sa government nga initial fund? So ingana nga research, so it's a profiling and technical evaluation of existing warehouses. So it's a good study, by the way. It's a good research for my advisee. Okay, the last component is there must be some environments to which the difficulty pertains. Always gina kanang mag-study ra ka nga nag-study lang ka kay para makapasar, I mean nag-thesis lang ka kay para makatesis ka, makapasar ka sa ABE, dili, there must be someone or some group of people nga imong matabangan. Okay. Like for example, during my master's thesis, so I have already helped the community or the farmer who cultivated or who's producing a lot of varieties of sweet potatoes in Malaysia. So after presenting to him my results, and then he know that this variety has the most in terms of perishability, it will prolong more than how many days than the other varieties without storing in what type of temperature. So inga na ba, the goal is to help a certain or a group of people to solve their hardships or difficulties, and it's a researchable area. Inga na lang gina siya, guys. Thus, a research problem is one which requires a researcher to find out the best solution for the given problem. Wala gani ka ka-solve or wala gani ka initiatives na nabuhat because you are not addressing the problem, and then it's not a research at all. You are just observing the problem. You are just asking what's the problem all about, but you are not addressing. Okay. Unsa gyud ka effective, sir, nga makaingon ko, sir, nga ang akong research is addressing the solution or solving the solution. For example, balik ta sa akong example, kadtong sa farmers nga might have the ang first assumption nato might be the problem is wala sila kabalo nga naay mga ingana advanced technologies. Ikaduha, might be kabalo sila pero dili sila kabalo mo operate. So walay education sa ila, walay training. Ikatulo, might be the problem there is no or there's a lack of support from the government. Okay? Or funding from the government, assistance from the government. Ikaupat, maybe the problem, no, assumption na to, the problem might be there's already a support from the government. They were already trained by the government or the certain institution. They are already aware, but they are not kanang handling or they are not operating it efficiently. Might be like that, no? As a group of, as an association. Nainganap po nga issue. Nga ang association gitagaan na sa government og multi-million funds, gitaga ang machineries, gitaga ang nagpandi, gitrain na sila, and then dili gyapon mo lago manuman the thinking of the some crab mentality kanang katapulan sa Pilipino ingana pud na a problem. So you can out of the four assumptions ingana na solve ba nato katong gi-identify nato nga problems. Okay, na assess ba nato? Assessment pasabot nag-study ka on what are the impacts and what are the pros and cons of this, and then identify nimo based sa imong survey or data gathering, and then na share nimo, and then na found out nimo. It's a research already because you have found the problems and then you have solved based on your initial findings. So inga na ra siya guys, ka simple, no? Nganong i-complicate pa man nimo if you can do a research that is very that is of high impact or very relevant to that particular situation or community. Okay, there are a lot of research or there are a lot of researchable areas sa EBE, no? I'm always thinking why most students will always resort to design, fabrication, mechanization. There are a lot, even the soil quality, the water quality, the products quality evaluation, non-destructive quality evaluation, post-harvest storage, etc., drying, a lot of studies to conduct. And when in terms of assessment and evaluation to related to the farmers or perceptions of the farmers, pwede. You can identify a problem with that scenario. A lot of things to consider. Okay? Factors daw po, accordingly, there are several factors which may result in making the problem complicated such as. Okay? Tanaw na to. Nganong dili man dayon dali makandak ang research? Tungod kay, after identifying the title or the topic, and then you already have the objectives. Gi-complicate pag yun nimo sa imong methods. Gipadaghan pag yun imong yuna-una. You are not that specific, no? You are still bound with your capacity nga makaya na ko ni i-conduct, makaya na ko ni ako gidning i-identify nga kuan. Pero nalimta na nimo nga ang research is specific to that particular problem nga imong i-identify, which is factor nga dili na hinuon nimo siya ma effectively carry. For example, the environment may change affecting the efficiencies of the courses of action or the values of the outcomes. Unsa man siya nga environment. For example, sa atong example na pud nga sa farmers, might be there's lack of support from the farmers or from the interviewees, no? Kanang mangayo ka sa ilang data or mangayo ka sa ilang surveyon nimo, di sila mo support, no? Wala sila active participation. So it might be a factor nga makakomplicate sa imong research problem. Another, the number of alternative courses of action may be very large. For example, nag-identify tag upat nga assumption. For example, katong nai support from the government, ikaduha, na-train na sila, ikatulo, aware sila, or naana sila capabilities niya, ikaupat, maybe wala gid sila interest. So, tungod sa ka-broad aning upat, might be, will complicate your study. So, you have to be specific or magpili lang kaasa dito. Okay? And, persons not involved in making the decision may be affected by it and react to it favorably or unfavorably. Okay? Kana bang ang imong study is katong sa farmers, pero ang imong gi-interview ang mga mayor, ang mga vice mayor, ang mga konsihal, ang kapitan. So you are not addressing the problem. You are not collecting the data properly. Okay? Kani ang imong study pero lahi ang imong group or ang imong population. Or pwede po nga sila, pero lahi ang imong mga questions na dili mo tubag sa certain problem. Ingana nga mga cases. Component 4, all other similar factors. Nga daghan pa kayong factors. Pwede po ang imong pag-research is grabe ra ka broad. Ikaduha, na-identify na nimo ang problem, pero ang imong mga questions, sama sa akong giingon, dili related nga matubag to nga problem. Ikatulo, ang imong method sa YUP, no? Kaupat, pag-analyze nimo sa data. So these things might complicate the problem na ang ending dili nimo siya ma-solve. So those are the factors that you have to consider. All such factors, or at least the important ones, may be thought of in context of a research problem. So kung maka-experience kag mag-ingana nga mga factors, ma-complicate gid ang imong study. So most problems or most difficulties in conducting or identify addressing the problem of a research kanang financial issues, time bound, kanang dili nimo makaya kay kulang sa time. Ikatulo, expertise or technicalities, wala kay kay idea in terms sa data analysis and interpretation. Ikaapat, ang review of related study, wala kaayo, ikapareho, so maglisod ka. So mostly nga na. Pero sa kana pa lang daang problem, pag identify pa lang nimo sa research problem, naana pud kay mga complications ana pareha ani, no? Maybe less of support, di gid nimo ma-identify kay naglisod gid ka kay pangutan-o nimo wala mo tubag. So may nga na ba? Or lisod ka reference mo nang di ka ka-design og ingani nga machine unsa kay related ani unsa kay properties. Ikatulo, wa gid kay idea, no? Kay sa properties of baby materials di ka maminaw unsa kay mga factors i-consider in terms of rolling or transporting a machine, kakabalo unsay frictional. Mahingana nga mga cases, so there are a lot of factors to consider. Okay, selecting the research problem undertaken for study must be carefully selected, no? Ako ra nang gibalik-balik. The task is a difficult one although it may not appear to be so. No, kanang identify naman ako ang title, sir. Mamuni akong title. Niya, yeah. Okay, ato ning kuan specific imong title. Okay, specific na. Unsa kay problems ani ha? Tuana dali yun. Naglisod unsa gid kay mga problems. Ngingani man ang imong title. So, siguro, no? Pinaka the best buhaton is i-identify sa gid ang problem usa pa ka mag-title. Okay? You identify first the problem and then you specify your problem, you state your problems before pa ka mag-title. Okay? Kay mas nindot to kaysa sa mag-title kadaan usa pa ka mag-identify sa problem or mag-state sa problem, which is complicated or distracting, no? Na naka title daan, di na dapat ma-change ang title kay na-approve na ni. Pero ang imo dayang statement of the problem nalimtan di ayog check. So dili pwede. Mas maayo una gid ka mag-identify sa problem. Okay. Selecting the research problem in a general concept, a problem must spring from the researcher's mind like a plant springing from its own seed. If your eyes need glasses, it is not the optician alone who decides about the number of the lens we require. We have to see ourselves and enable him to prescribe for us. Mogyud. Okay? This is right. Identifying the problem is not all about identifying the problem because of you want it to do. You want it to achieve something. But because, again, we have to address and then we have to solve anything that is unsolved. No? We have to solve something that is unsolved. And then, for example, ingon siya, kanang nadaw kay daot sa mata, okay? Nganong maingon, dili ka makaingon nga, kanang ang optometrist gid ang makahatag sa ako og kanang enough nga kanang sakto nga kanang sukod sa akong lens kay CRI expert. No, the optometrist will also ask you unsa di ay unsa may imong bation kung kani nga lens imong gamiton, unsa ni sakto nga sukod sa imo, wala kay di ka magsuka ana ba. So you address the problem based on your findings, but not just based on your thoughts, but also based on the findings and the methods on how you solve the problem. So ingana siya ang concept. Okay, so the general rule, first you have to identify the problem area and then learn more about the problem. For example, practical research, issues with performances or efficiency in an organization, processes that could be improved, areas of concern among practitioners, difficulties faced. Sama sa akong example gaina, katong sa mga farmers, katong sa bangko, no, posible mao to pwede address. Water quality, no, mga practical research. Kung theoretical research, mao na to siya mga phenomenal studies, phenomenon, no, katubang perspective na nagkikisolve, like machineries, may nga na kay gusto isolve, quality assurance, i-identify nimo unsa kaha ang mga defect, no? Defect detection sa mga quality sa products para makuha nang ilaw. Mag-sorting ka, mag-sizing or grading ka sa products based on your kuan. So may nga na siya mga theoretical. And then behind that, unsa man day background sa study kung kanong mga practical, kinsay maapektuhan, unsa di ay dayon kung naana ko ani nga data, no? Kinsa man gid ang makabenefit niya, unsa man dayon, no? Mulago ba, maingana ba? So mao na nga contextual niya nga mga background. And then sa theoretical, ang iyang relevance, no? Unsa ka importante, unsa dayon kung kani nga problema akong isolve, no? Kinsa kahay makabenefit pud, no? Unsa nga panahon, unsa nga lugar, kinsa nga tao ang mapukusan ani, no? Unsa pa kaha, unsa nga mga aspeto nga ako ma-address, no? What will be the consequence? What if kani ang resulta o gana So ingana siya ang kanang pag-research nimo, pag-select nimo sa problem. Kinsay maka-benefit, no? Maka-benefit ba pud kaha, no? Sakto ba ka akong method na ma-answer nako or ma-solve ning problem. So you have to follow and then you have to consider a lot of things when doing the research. And then points to consider, the following points may be observed by a researcher in selecting a research problem or a subject for research. The first one, subject which is overdone should not be normally chosen. Kana bang daghan nag-study ana, nganong kana pagidihapon imong study? Okay. Okay. Modification of mechanical kuan kanang coconut splitting splitter. Ano na daghan naman na ano may coconut splitter, ano may gana pa magiga? Why not the other studies na po? Ano ba? And controversial subject should not become the choice of an average researcher. Kung bago pa lang, baguhan pa lang, ayaw na kayo pag kuan, ayaw na kayo pag study nga magbuhat kag vaccine nga wala kay resources, di pagid kay nga naka expert niyo. Nganong mag-research maka about vaccine, COVID vaccine nga. Nana may mga daggo nga companies o mga international experts nga nagandak ana. So, makadugang ra ka sa curious sa kuan, sa issue. Okay? Mga nga mga concern. Too narrow or too vague problem should be avoided. Kana bang grabe ra, murag bugat ra kayo nga problem nga imong solbon. So, mag-specify lang ka unsa atong nga problem imong gusto i-address. Sama sa atong example nga upat ka concerns or issues atong gi-assume. So, mag-identify lang ka. Maybe kadtong lack of training. So, i-conduct nimo research about lack of training. What if i-train na sila? Unsa na dayon? Mangana ba? Okay? The subject selected for research should be familiar and feasible so that the related research material or sources or of research are within one's reach, no? Dapat familiar ka, di kay magpataka-taka ra ka. Ang imong interest is more on the water related na field sa ABA, pero ang imo di ang i-research kay machinery, which is di nga ni ka kabalo mag-sketch up, di ka kabalo magamit og AutoCAD. So, you have to be you have to consider your capabilities on your personal's reach or person's personal ni mga capabilities. Okay, lisod man na mag-research na magpahada-hada ka nga, I want to do this because I learned this from my subject without knowing the financial or financial issues or financial capabilities, technical capabilities, knowledge, know-how, no? So ingana siya guys. The importance of the subject, no, the qualifications and the training of the researcher, no, the cost involved. So ako lang nabalik, no, kung kaya ba ginako ni, no, kanang sakto ba ka ang akong kuan, mag-prospect ba ka na ako kinsa akong adviser kung mauni, and then I want to consult him her if sakto ba akong mindset, sakto ba ni nga na identify na akong problem, sakto ba ni nga method, so mauni akong i-propose. So makaya ba na ako ni, no, na namino ba ka ako sa akong properties of AB material, sa akong machinery nga subject. So you have to consider these points. And then selection of a problem must be preceded by a preliminary study. This may not be necessary when the problem requires the conduct of a research closely similar to one that has already been done. For example, nag-study ka nga existing na siya. You just want to innovate something or modify something sa kana nga machine. Like existing na gyud nga naay coconut splitter. But you really want to design or modify that splitter to make it more efficient, no? Ang iyang maximum efficiency dito is 90%. Gusto nimo i-100. Kay curious gig ka. So what are the recommendations of the previous researcher you want to modify, okay? So imo gyung i-achieve, okay? And then dili na ka pwede nga mag preliminary, pwede ra nga dili na ka mag preliminary study because there's already existing data nga iyang available. So magkanda ka sa imo based sa imong actual and then i-compare nimo sa iya. Pero if you are doing that as a unique study, it's the first time study nga gi-conduct, then you have to do a preliminary. For example, there are already studies conducted on evaluating the water quality of Tagu River, Tagu Surigao del Sur River. Naana sila na evaluate nga naana sila data available nga mauni ang iyang water indices, quality indices. And then ikaw gusto po nimo magkanda kag study sa Surigao City nga river, okay? So you have to do the preliminary because you are not doing on the same place or on the same area, no, lahi man imong study area. So you still have you have to do a preliminary study so that before ka makapadayon sa imong actual na gyud nga kuan. Preliminary means magkuha sa kag sampling nga imo sang i-test or i-analyze nga sakto ba ang imong method nga magamit, and then dito na dayon ka sa aktual ang kabuuan na dayon nimo ang imong i-apply or imong i-conduct, no, preliminary sa siya. Pero kung nani nag-conduct ana, which is similar to water quality nga nani data unya, pero ang imo is lahi lang ang method, ayaw na pag preliminary, kay pwede na to nimo siya magamit as your reference, okay, comparable nga data. Okay, nga na ra siya ang iyang concept sa research. And then for example, on my experience, naghanag nag-study on the application of image processing sa various crops. However, wala pa'y nagamit sa sweet potatoes in a different variety. So what I did is I did a preliminary study first, and then I analyzed, okay. And then I found out nga, okay, kung magamit din ko aning method, medyo malangan ko something somehow. So online to, nag-adjust na din ako, and then na din kay actual nga testing, nga straight na ka, continue na ka, wala na ng mga problema nga may encounter. So that's how the importance of preliminary study. Okay? And then accordingly, if the subject for research is selected properly by observing the above mentioned points, the research will not be boring drudgery. Mao gyud. Okay? So if gipang consider na nimo daan ang mga possible nga important considerations, labi ng kaning mga points of consideration, your study will not be boring at all. It will not be like stagnant at all, like ay kapuyan na di ko magkandak eh, o di ko kabalo nga ingani di ay kagasto, okay? Kung imo na ladaan giunahuna the possible outcomes along the way, katong gipang set ta to ganina nga conditions, and then you already know what may be. Why are you proposing this study, why are you proposing this or addressing this problem if financially di ka maka afford ani mga testing mga instruments, or dili di ka pwede, you cannot have it because kinahanglan siya og everyday nga observation Monday to Sunday, and then you cannot have because of your religious or your belief. So why? So do not do that. You have to consider your personal, your educational, your academic or your knowledge on doing the research. So dili magpahada-hada, according to the capabilities lang or according to considerations. That's how important all of this when you select your research. Okay. Necessities, an approved clearly stated is a problem half solved. Okay? A problem clearly stated is a problem half solved, no? If you have identified, if you have stated the problem correctly, it already means or it is a good indication that your problem has been solved initially, okay? Daghan na kang gibuhat, you have a lot of testing, you have measured a lot, grabe na nga instrument na manigamit. Pero sayup di ay ang imong method nga nagamit kay sayup ang imong pag-state sa problem, then you are not addressing the problem at all. Okay, the one thing I have experienced with this before, nice studenting, nahuman na siya collect sa data, nahuman na siya analyze sa data, pero ang kantong mga na-analyze niya wala ni relate sa iyang problem or sa iyang topic. So what the advisor did, gi-change na lang ang iyang title ug ang iyang statement of the problem, which is not a good thing at all. Okay, the first thing is you are doing this because you want to solve something that you have already stated or clearly stated before. It's not a good thing na itwist nimo. Humana ka gather sa data, humana ka analyze and write your results, then before pa ka mag-change sa imong study, a title or sa imong problem. No. Because you are doing that because of the prerequisite, which is to identify the problem, no? So sayup siya. Yeah. Mao lagi na kay para maka-graduate. So it's not a good experience. Okay? It's not a good experience at all. So mga necessities, these are all the necessities. The problem to be investigated must be defined, okay? A proper definition of research problem, okay? Balik lang siya, will be enabled the researcher to be on the track, no? Wala, sama sa akong na mention, if you are not defining the problem well, you will be confused, and then you are not guided, you are not on the right track while doing your research, okay? And questions like what data are to be collected, what characteristics of data are relevant and need to be studied. Dapat you already knew that, no? While doing or conduct. Okay, example, your research is to measure the fuel ratio, consumption ratio of that particular biomass, no? And then nag-solve di ka sa iya og you are solving the moisture content, you are solving the mass of that fuel nga na-consume. And then you are measuring the temperature of the environment. And then you are also measuring the, for example, the color, no? So, unsay relationship sa color or sa fuel consumption ratio, no? or ang effectiveness sa kana nga fuel. So wala na, no? So if nonsense, if it's not applicable and not relevant or it's irrelevant, do not include it in your study. It will just bug your study, no? It will just give you an ambiguous thinking. And then similar other questions crop up in the mind of the researcher who can well plan his strategy. So strategize na dapat nimo ang imong methods ug ang imong data collection nga techniques or strategies. Dili kay along the process diha pa ka magkuan. Nag-analyze na ka sa data, imo na pong i-manipulate ang data kay sayop di ay sa imong method. So it's not good. Okay? And lastly, defining a research problem properly is a prerequisite for any study and is a step of the highest importance, no? Identify the problem correctly. Okay? Define your problem correctly. State your problem clearly and correctly so that along the process of your research, you are guided. You are not misguided. Okay? Irrelevant data, irrelevant parameters are usually occurred once you are not guided with the correct problem. Okay? Mao gyud na may tabo. Nganong nagkuha man kaani? Nganong nasayop man nimo pagkuha ang data, no? Nganong wala man nimo gisolve ni nga kabalo man ka nga mao ni ang importante? Unsaon pa kung mana siya adto sa area? So mubalik na pud, mugasto na pud. Like that examples. Okay? It is only on the careful detailing of the research problem that we can work out the research design and can smoothly carry on all the consequential steps involved while doing research, no? Di na ta pwede magbasol-basol nga. Ay, nasayop di ko. Dahil na ako na-measure ang measure content na. Wa na. Humana ang sample. Gilabay na. Okay? So, you must be guided with your methods and your conduct of research once everything is well strategized, everything is well planned, and everything is identified and clearly done based on your statement of the problem or your topic. Dili kay humana nimo ato na lang i-adjust, tanggalo na lang ninga objective, tanggalo na lang ninga problem kay para safe ta. So it's not a good research at all, because that is why you are being advised or required to propose before doing the research. It's not about doing the research first and then propose. Propose means mao ni ang imong concept, mao ni ang imong problems nga gusto i-solve, and then you address that, you do the data collection and then address and interpret and then defend again, and then let's show or to show if the problem that you have proposed has been addressed based on your activities conducted. Ingana siya, guys. No? So I hope that you have a clear understanding on how to define or clearly state the research problems. So sa una, maybe ang inyong conception, if ang research problem is mao lang ni, no? Ibutang lang sa paper, i-input lang sa manuscript, correctionan sa advisor. No. The research problem must be identified accordingly based on the topic that you have identified. Okay? Mas maayo gani nga una nimo i-identify ang problem before ka magbutang sa imong title or sa imong topic. Okay? So I hope that you have learned a lot on the how to identify on how to clearly state the problem. So most techniques are just common, like for example, the researcher should be defined in a systematic manner, which I already discussed. Okay, the technique for the purpose involves the undertaking of the following steps. So this one, statement of the problem must be in a general way, and then you have to narrow down or to be specific. Okay, you understand the problem. To survey the available literature if there is. If none, then it's a unique study. You are doing it alone. But it's not a bad thing that since walay lain literature or available literature, di na dai nimo i-pursue. Maybe because nobody got the interest to do that. So you are the only person who have the interest. So just continue, regardless if there's available literature. Somehow you can help the community or the group of people. And then rephrasing the research problem into a working proposition. Katubang kani ang research problem, unya specific naman ko, ako na po siyang i-change into a specific type. Dili kay katong broad gihapon. Pero ang akong objective raba kay wala na belong. So ingana siya ang pasabot. Okay? And then, developing the ideas through a series of discussions. Maybe your classmate, your instructors, professors, or teachers, or people who are more expert on research, imong i-consult nga, unsa di ay ang mas nindot paani, unsa kahay implications if kani nga problem ang akong gusto i-solve. Okay? So, I hope that you are now guided or you are now knowledgeable enough in terms of selecting or identifying and even clearly stating the problems of research so that you will be guided when you do your research or you, your future endeavors when you graduate the ABE, when you become a professional ABE. Okay? So the last one is the statement of the problem in a general way. So the researcher must immerse himself. So you are already immersed if you already know the problem, right? And then understanding the nature of the problem. You have to identify or you have to understand what the problem is really all about. How can I help? You know? What will be the possible conditions? Ito akong ipang set ganina. Okay. And then surveying the available literature, Maudlo. If there is none, then it's okay. If there are more, it's also okay. So there's nothing. It's better if there are available literature particular or related to your current thinking or your current thoughts. Then developing the ideas through discussions. More the expert can tell you and can help you in and can guide you in narrowing down or specifying your research in order for you to have a good method and a good conduct of the data collection. Okay, and other things to consider in defining the research problem might be technicalities like after research, after doing the research, the technical like how will you arrange your findings or how will you interpret the data and then so on and so on. But I guess the following topics will also teach you on the literature survey, how to do proper literature survey, how to present the research, how to analyze the research, and how we can publish the research. So I hope that you are now guided on from the most trends of ABE researches up to the research process, up to the selection of a research problem, and then so specifying the objectives up to literature survey and so on and so on. So I think that's all for this presentation. So I hope that you have learned a lot, you have gained a lot based on my discussion. So thank you so much, guys, and be ready for a short long quiz for particularly for these topics 1 to 5, which covers including selection of a research problem. So thank you, guys, and God bless us all.